press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello children, subject EVS, topic nature of matter, class 5th. Okay, in previous class we already study about what is matter, isn't it children? Yes, we see several materials or objects in our daily life and we are using a few of them, isn't it? These materials are called matters. Okay, next we see here, in this class we study about matter or object. Okay, how are the materials available in nature created? How are the materials available in nature created? Okay, see here children, experiment. How are the materials available in nature created? Okay, next section, matter or object. So you can see so many materials surround us, right? Both natural and man-made, isn't it children? Here we see two types of materials, natural materials and man-made materials, isn't it? You can see man-made materials like benches, books, pen, paper, water bottle and many more, etc. Okay, and we can see so many natural materials also, like plants, trees, flowers, soil and many other things, isn't it children, etc. So how are these materials available in nature or created? Once again, we have so many materials surround us, both natural materials and man-made material. Okay, man-made materials. Man-made materials like benches, pen, chalk piece, duster, isn't it children? Pen, papers, water bottle, etc. And natural materials like plants, trees, flowers, soils and etc. children, okay. So how are these materials available in nature or created children? How are these materials created? To understand this, let us do an experiment children. See here, in this experiment we are taking some chalk powder. Here we taking some chalk powder children, understood? Okay, when we dip our finger in it and sprinkle slowly over a plain surface, then we observe surface carefully through a convex. Okay, we observe through a convex lens, using a convex lens children, we can have a magnifying effect. Once again children, in this experiment we are taking some chalk powder. We are taking some chalk powder. Okay, when we dip our finger in it and sprinkle slowly over a plain surface, okay, then we observe surface, plain glass surface, okay children, plain glass surface, then we observe surface carefully children through a convex lens, using a convex lens, we can have a magnifying effect. When you can observe small particles, see here, we can observe here small particles, isn't it? Understood children? So once again I will repeat here, in experiment you can take chalk powder children. When you dip your finger in it and sprinkle slowly over a plain glass surface children, understood? And then we you observe surface carefully through a convex lens, using a convex lens, what happened children? We can have a magnifying effect. When you see, or when you can observe small particles, see here, small particles children, understood? Small particles bigger, okay? You must be able to see small, small individual chalk particles. Understood? Chalk particles. Right, children? Do you think we can divide the particles for, there can be, take one of those particles and cut it more? Do you think it is possible, children? So our children is saying it is not possible. It is not possible for us to divide them further. Here we see here, children. We can observe that although we try with our own hands, it is not possible will divide further, children. Okay. So it is not possible for us with our hands to divide the chalk particles. Okay. Chalk particles further. Once again, see here, children. Take some chalk powder, dip your finger and sprinkle slowly over a plain glass surface. Wow, observe these minute pieces carefully through a convex lens. Okay, can see minute pieces be divided further, children? It is not possible. Why it is not possible for us to divide them further? We can observe that the finest pieces of chalk cannot divide further through, sorry, though we try to do so, okay, children. Scientifically, materials are called matter. Scientifically, materials are called matter. Scientifically, materials are called what, children? Matter. Okay? Matter made up of small particles. Observe here, children. Matter made up of small particles. Matter made up of small particles. Okay? The smallest piece of matter called particle. Matter is called particle. Understood, children? Once again, see here. So, if we can observe that although we try, isn't it, children, with our own hands, it is not possible. We'll divide further, isn't it? So, it is not possible for us with our hands to divide that chalk particle further. Scientifically, materials are called as matter. Okay, and matter is made up of small particles, children. The smallest piece of matter is called as particle. Okay, students. So although the chalk particles is not able to be divided by you, okay, that present mean it is the single particle. It is made up of many smaller particles which we cannot see with our naked eyes. Okay, we will learn more about them in our future class, children. Okay, once again, scientifically, materials are called as matter, and matter is made up of small particles. Okay, the smallest pieces of matter is called as particle. So, although the chalk particle is not able to be divided by you children further, okay, the present mean it is the single particle. It is made up of many smaller particles which we cannot see with our eyes. We will learn naked eyes, okay, we'll learn more about in next classes, okay, in future classes. Okay, children, see here. ಅಂದರೆ ನಾವು ಸೀಮೆ ಸುಣ್ಣದ ಪುಡಿಯನ್ನು ಏನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಎಷ್ಟು ಸಣ್ಣ ಸಣ್ಣ ಪುಡಿ ಮಾಡಿದರೂ ಕೂಡ ಕೊನೆಗೂ ಇನ್ನೂ ಚಿಕ್ಕದು ಮಾಡಲಾಗದ ಸಣ್ಣ ಚೂರುಗಳನ್ನು ಕಾಣುತ್ತೇವೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ನಾವು ಚಾಕ್ ಪೀಸನ್ನು ತಗೋಬೇಕು, ಅದನ್ನು ಪುಡಿ ಎಷ್ಟೇ ನಾವು ಸಣ್ಣ ಸಣ್ಣ ಪುಡಿ ಮಾಡಿದರೂ ಕೂಡ ಮತ್ತೆ ಆ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸನ್ನು ಮತ್ತೆ ನಾವು ಚೂರು ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ಚಿಕ್ಕದು ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಸಣ್ಣ ಚೂರುಗಳನ್ನು ಕಾಣುತ್ತೇವೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಅಂದರೆ ಸೀಮೆ ಸಣ್ಣ ಪುಡಿಯನ್ನು ನಾವು ಎಷ್ಟೇ ಸಣ್ಣ ಸಣ್ಣ ಪುಡಿ ಮಾಡಿದರೂ ಕೂಡ ಕೊನೆಗೆ ಇನ್ನೂ ಚಿಕ್ಕದು ಮಾಡಲಾಗದು. ಓಕೆ, ಸಣ್ಣ ಸಣ್ಣ ಚೂರುಗಳನ್ನು ನಾವಿಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡ್ತೀವಿ. ವಸ್ತುವನ್ನು ವೈಜ್ಞಾನಿಕವಾಗಿ ಏನಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ? ದ್ರವ್ಯ ಅಥವಾ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಲಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ದ್ರವ್ಯಗಳಲ್ಲಿರುವ ಅತ್ಯಂತ ಸಣ್ಣ ದ್ರವ್ಯಗಳೆಲ್ಲವೂ ಕೂಡ ಅತ್ಯಂತ ಸಣ್ಣ ಕಣಗಳಿಂದ ಅವು ಆಗ್ತವೆ, ಕಣಗಳಿಂದಾಗಿವೆ. ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್, ವಸ್ತುವನ್ನು ನಾವೇನಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ? ಸೈಂಟಿಫಿಕಲಿ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್. ವಸ್ತುವನ್ನು ನಾವು ವೈಜ್ಞಾನಿಕವಾಗಿ ದ್ರವ್ಯ ಎಂದು ಕರೆಯುತ್ತೇವೆ. ದ್ರವ್ಯಗಳೆಲ್ಲವೂ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಮೇಡ್ ಅಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್. ದ್ರವ್ಯಗಳೆಲ್ಲವೂ ಅತ್ಯಂತ ಸಣ್ಣ ಕಣಗಳಿಂದಾಗಿವೆ. ದ್ರವ್ಯಗಳೆಲ್ಲವೂ ಕೂಡ ಅತ್ಯಂತ ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಕಣಗಳಿಂದ ಆಗಿವೆ. ದ್ರವ್ಯದ ಅತಿ ಸೂಕ್ಷ್ಮವಾದ ಚೂರನ್ನು ಏನಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ? ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್. ದ್ರವ್ಯದ ಅತಿ ಸೂಕ್ಷ್ಮವಾದ ಚೂರನ್ನು ಕಣ ಅಥವಾ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಎಂದು ಕರೆಯಲಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ದ ಸ್ಮಾಲೆಸ್ಟ್ ಪೀಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್. ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್? ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್? ದ ಸ್ಮಾಲೆಸ್ಟ್ ಪೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂದರೆ ವಸ್ತುವಿನ ದ್ರವ್ಯದ ಅತಿ ಸೂಕ್ಷ್ಮವಾದ ಚೂರನ್ನು ನಾವು ಕಣ ಎಂದು ಕರೆಯುತ್ತೇವೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್? ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ಪೇಜ್ ನಂಬರ್ 133. ಥಿಂಕ್, ರೀಡ್ ದ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸಸ್ given below and try to remember if you have experienced any. How did fragrant particles reach your nose from the open scent bottle, children? How did your nose feel that the neighboring room is being swept? Did you notice any collection of dark particles when firewood is burned or kerosene lamp is lit? Okay, once again, so whenever I open a scent bottle or a green bottle, you would smell a very nice smell coming from it. Okay, how did those particles of the scent come from the scent bottle to your nose? Understood, children? Next question is, how does your nose feel the neighboring room is being swept? Suppose you are sitting in your classroom, children, and there is neighboring room that being cleaned. Okay, and there is lot of dust particles coming from there. You would start sneezing, isn't it, children? You would start sneezing and coughing, correct, children, isn't it? Once again, listen here. You are sitting in your classroom, children. There is neighboring room that being cleaned and there is a lot of dust particles coming from there, children. You would start sneezing and coughing, correct, isn't it, children? Yes. So how did those particles come from there to your room, children? Did you notice any collection of dark particles when a firewood is burned or kerosene lamp is lit? So if you have observed in your houses, wherever keep lamps, if you see the roof, you would notice some small dark particles on the roof, isn't it, children? Also, when you look carefully at the area where firewood is burnt, you will not list collection of dark particles. What happened to the firewood on the oil where the dark particles come from, children? In this lesson, we are going to answer these questions, children. Okay, particles present in matter, isn't it? Particles present in matter. Okay, matter are invisible. Particles present in matter are invisible. Okay, particles present in matter are invisible. ಅವು ನಮಗೆ ಕಣ್ಣಿಗೆ ಕಾಣಿಸೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಆ ಕಣಗಳು, ಆ ಚೂರುಗಳು ನಮ್ಮ ಕಣ್ಣಿಗೆ ಕಾಣಿಸೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ವಾ? ಸೊ ಲೈಕ್ ವಿ ಲರ್ನ್ ಆಲ್ ವಿ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸಿ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಚಾಕ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಮೆನಿ ಮೆನಿ ಮೋರ್ ಇನ್ವಿಸಿಬಲಿ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಓಕೆ ಸರ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ matter is made up of minute means what, children? See here, matter is made up of very minute. Minute means what? Small, very small. minute means what children? Very small. Matter is made up of very minute particles. Minute means what children? What children? Small particles. Small, very small. Once again, listen here. Particles present in matter are invisible. So, although we are able to see small particles of chalk, in that particle, many more invisibly small particles are there, are present. Okay? Matter is made up of very minute particles. Hence, visible matter consists of invisible particles. Visible matter consists of invisible particles. Okay? Once again, children, I will ask a question, true or false. Matter is made up of particles which cannot be seen by our eyes. It is true or false, children? False, children. Think. It is true. Isn't it? Matter is made up of particles which cannot be seen by our eyes. It is true. This statement is true. Matter is made up of particles which cannot be seen by our eyes. They are invisible to our eyes. Okay? We can see them with the help of very powerful equipment. What is this, student? Like microscope. Okay? What do you mean by matter, children? See here, page number 133 here. We have one question, children. What do you mean by matter? Once again, particles present in the matter are invisible. Matter is made up of very minute particles. Visible matter consists of invisible particles. Okay? What do you mean by matter, children? Answer is, scientifically, materials are called matter. Isn't it, children? Visible matter is made up of invisible particles. Once again, children, scientifically, materials are called matter. Scientifically, here, write down, children. Scientifically, materials are called matter. Materials are called matter, isn't it? Visible matter is made up of invisible particles. Visible matter is made up of invisible particles. Visible matter is made up of invisible particles. Invisible particles. Invisible particles. Once again, children, scientifically, materials are called matter. Visible matter is made up of invisible particles. These are two things we learned about matter. Scientifically, materials are called matter. Visible matter is made up of invisible particles. Here we learn two things we learned about matter. These are two things we learned about matter, children. Okay? See here, activity, collect the paste and available pictures of matter in the following boxes. You will do this activity, children. Okay? Next, activity, page number 134. See here, take a material, make it into minute pieces. You have to take a material, make it into minute pieces. Write the name of the matter which you have divided into minute pieces. What, children? Particles. You have to write down here, particles. Isn't it? We already learnt it. Visible matter consists of invisible particles. Isn't, children? Particles. particles present in the matter are invisible. Matter is made up of very minute particles. Visible matter consists of invisible particles, isn't it? Matter, visible matter is made up of invisible particles. Okay, take a material. You have to do this activity. Take a material, make it into minute pieces. Write the name of the matter which you have divided into minute pieces. It is particles. Next one is collect the powder of available matter and exhibit it in your classroom. Collect the powder of available matter and exhibit it in your classroom, children. Okay. Supposing you have divided a. Once again, so like we already learned. So, we divided something into minute pieces. We can call it as particles of that matter. Isn't it, children? Answer is particles. Supposing you have divided a pieces of paper, then what happened? They would be called as particles of paper. Once again, listen here. You have divided a piece of paper. Then they would be called as particles of paper. You can collect the available of matter and show your friends to your classroom, children. Okay. Next, we study about, once again, see here, properties of matter. In this class, we study about properties of matter. Dravyada lakshanagalu, properties of matter. Now, we study about properties of matter. Okay, properties of matter. Matters have special properties. These properties can be understood with the help of some experiments and activities also. Okay, see here, children, page number 134. Okay, in the next part is we will be learning about the properties of matter. So matter has special properties. These properties can be understood with the help of some activities. Okay, the first property of matter is matter occupies space. Matter occupies space. First properties of matter is matter occupies space. Matter occupies space. Okay. Matter, first property of properties of matter is matter occupies space, children. If you see the matter around you, supposing you have kept a pen on your table. You kept a pen on your table. See here, what happened? Then if you want to keep another pencil or another pen on the exact same location, children, you want to able to do it, children. You will be able to either keep it on top of the pen, or you have to move the pen on the table and then keep it. Isn't it, children? Once again, listen here. If you see the matter around you, supposing you have kept a pen on your table, children, what happened? Then if you want to keep another pencil or another material, then if you want to keep another pencil or another pen on the exact same location, it is possible, children? No. You want to able to do it? No. You will able to either keep it on top of the pen, or you have to move the pen on the table, isn't it? And then keep it in the same position. This is because the pen Anivar table occupies its own space. It occupies its own space. Now let us look at the activity to understand this property more, children. See here, the activity is, pour the wheat flour or any other flour into bowl. Okay, from a box you have to pour wheat flour or any flour into the bowl. Again try to fill the bowl so that the flour does not spill. So if you can see here, what is happening, children, is this bowl already filled with the flour. Okay, next you are trying to add more flour to the same bowl. It is not possible to add more flour to the same bowl, correct, children? Yes, because it will overspill. Let us another question one by one, children. See here, was it possible, children? It is possible. We can see that it was not possible, isn't it, children? It was not possible, because once the bowl is full, the flour will overspill, right, children? Next question is, did you complete fill the bowl? In this lesson, we are going to listen. Did you complete fill the bowl, children? Next question is, did you completely fill the bowl, children? Yes. If we pour it from the box carefully, we will be able to completely fill the bowl. What should be done to pour some more flour into the bowl? Why, children? If you want to use the bowl again, you have to transfer the flour that is already there in the bowl, okay, to some other container, and then use the bowl to pour some more flour. Okay, why is that so? Because once it is already containing maximum quantity of flour, children, you cannot more flour to it. Okay, bowl, the volume is completely filled. The bowl volume is completely filled. It was impossible to fill the bowl completely with entire quantity of the flour present in the box. Why, children? So they are asking, why can't we transfer everything to the box, to the bowl, children? If the box is big and contains more flour and the bowl is small, cannot and hold that quantity of flour. We cannot transfer it completely. To the bowl, because the volume that is occupied either flour in the box is more than the volume of the bowl. So even the wheat flour need has to go right. Okay, even we need to some place sit down, just like that wheat flour also need some place to go. Okay, if it is did you occupied other wheat flour, this wheat flour will not be able to go into the same place. This is because wheat flour needs a space, because wheat flour occupies space. Okay, so I have given a brief answer, children, to that question. More flour is present in box, wheat flour needs space. More flour is present in box, wheat flour needs space. Okay, see here, the experiment, next experiment, page number 135. Experiment is, put a glass beaker completely filled with water on a plate. Slowly immerse a stone of appropriate size tied with a thread in the beaker as shown in the picture. Okay, see here, children, ಒಂದು ಜಾಡಿಗೆ ಅಥವಾ ಒಂದು ಬೀಕರಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವೇನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ನೀರನ್ನು ತುಂಬಬೇಕು, ಅದನ್ನು ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಇಡಬೇಕು. ಓಕೆ, ನಿಧಾನವಾಗಿ ಫಿಲ್ ದ ವಾಟರ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್, ಸ್ಲೋಲಿ ಇಮರ್ಸ್ ಆ ಸ್ಟೋನ್. ಒಂದು ಕಲ್ಲನ್ನು ನಾವೇನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ನಿಧಾನವಾಗಿ ಆ ಬೀಕರ್ನ ಒಳಗೆ ಹಾಕಬೇಕು. ಅವಾಗ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಇವಾಗ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಆ ಬೀಕರ್ ನೀರಿಂದ ತುಂಬಿದೆ, ತುಂಬ ನೀರನ್ನು ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಎಷ್ಟು ಹಿಡಿಯುತ್ತೆ ಅಷ್ಟು ನೀರನ್ನು ನಾವು ಏನು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ, ತುಂಬಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ನೀರು ತುಂಬ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ತುಂಬಿ ನಾವು ಇಡ್ತಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಇವಾಗ ನಾವು ಏನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಒಂದು ಕಲ್ಲನ್ನು ತಗೊಂಡು ನಿಧಾನವಾಗಿ ಆ ಕಲ್ಲನ್ನು ನಾವು ಒಳಗೆ ಹಾಕಬೇಕು, ಸೇರಿಸ್ಬೇಕು. ಅವಾಗ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ನೀರು ಅಂದರೆ ಆ ಸ್ಟೋನ್ ಏನು ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಜಾಗವನ್ನು ಆಕ್ರಮಿಸಿದಾಗ ಆ ಜಾಗ ಅಷ್ಟು ಭಾಗದ ನೀರು ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಹೊರಗೆ ಚಲ್ಲುತ್ತೆ. ಇಸ್ಂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ವೆನ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೋನ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಮರ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬೀಕರ್, ವೈ ಡಿಡ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಸ್ಪಿಲ್ ಔಟ್, ಯಾಕೆ ನೀರು ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಚಲ್ಲುತ್ತೆ, ವೈ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೋ, ಥಿಂಕ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಟು ಯುವರ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್, ಸೊ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಎ ಬೀಕರ್, ಫಿಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ವಿತ್ ವಾಟರ್, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ಫಿಲ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಟಿಲ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಪುಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಎ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್, ಓಕೆ, ಟು ಅವಾಯ್ಡ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಓವರ್ ಸ್ಪಿಲಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪುಟಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್. ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಎ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಸ್ಟೋನ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಟೈ ಟು ಎ ಥ್ರೆಡ್, ಓಕೆ. ವೆನ್ ಯು ಸ್ಲೋಲಿ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೋನ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಬೀಕರ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಶೋನ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದಟ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಪಿಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಬೀಕರ್, ಇಸ್ಂಟ್ ಇಟ್. When you slowly inverse the stone into the beaker, what happened? Water is spilling out from the beaker. What happened when the stone is inverse into the beaker, children? So as when you slowly inverse the stone, water will start spilling out, isn't it, children? Yes. Why did water spill out? Why did water spill out? Why, children? We have learned that matter needs its own space. Matter needs its own space. Okay? Correct? When the glass was completely filled with water, there is no more space left for the stone. When you are inversing the stone, something needs to make for the stone. So what is happening is that much of water is flowing out to make space for the stone. That much water is flowing out to make space for the stone. From this activity, we can learn that matter occupies space. Understood children, matter occupies space. Basis of the first property of the matter, here learning it is that matter occupies space. A matter cannot occupy the place of another at the same time. So two things cannot occupy the same space at the same time. That is why water spill out to make space the stone. Okay, see here children, matter occupies space, or matter cannot occupy the place of another at a same time. Write the names of some matter around you, children. Okay, this is an activity that you can do on your own. What you have to do as a sit down in one place and look at the substances around you. There may be books, pens, water bottle, cup, plate, etc. Okay, around you, children. You need to make a list of those materials around you. They have given us one hint. Air is also, air is a matter, isn't it, children? So there is air also around you, although you cannot see. Okay, air is a matter. Air occupies space in its container. Okay, air is a matter, air occupies space in its container. We learned about this in our lesson air occupy space in a container. We did many experiments about this. One experiment is, children, see here, blowing air into the balloon. Balloon that was small becomes big because air occupies space, isn't it, children? When we are blowing air into the balloons, what happened? When we are blowing air into the balloon, what happened? Balloon that was small becomes big because air occupies space. They have repeated the same experiment here, children, isn't it? Activity is blow air into a balloon. Okay, particles in the air are rarely distributed. So particles of the one matter can be accommodated in another. In which particles are rarely distributed, children? Okay. So they are saying particles are, one matter can be accommodate another in which particles are rarely distributed. Okay, this means if particles are sitting far away from each other, okay, you put enough pressure into them, they can move closer to each other and can make space for extra particles. Okay, so you might have observed observe this in any balls, like throw balls, volleyballs, etc. Okay, when not completely air inside them, they would have become soft, isn't it? Not easy to play with. You need to pump air into these particles. Okay, how do you pump air into the ball, children? Ball, volleyball. Okay, put pressure using a pump. Air was already present into the balls, but when you put in more air, they become more completely distributed and become high pressure particles. Okay, once again, when you put in more air, they become more completely distributed and become high pressure particles. Okay. Thank you, children.